Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and today we are going to add polynomials using both the vertical method as well as the horizontal method. So, let's get right into it. Let's consider two different examples, starting with this one, in which we have just one variable, and that is x. When adding polynomials, our job is really just to combine like terms. And like terms are those that have exactly the same variables. And when I say exactly the same, I mean exactly the same. X is not exactly the same as x squared. So these are not like terms. While x squared is not exactly the same as x cubed, which means these are also not like terms. In fact, we call these unlike terms. However, negative 3x and 8x both have exactly the same variable of x, and so they are like terms. Just as 11x cubed and 4x cubed have exactly the same variable, x cubed, which means that they are like terms. The constant terms are also considered like terms because they can both be written with the variable x to the power of 0, exactly the same variable. There are two different methods for us to choose from when it comes to adding polynomials. Those are the horizontal method as well as the vertical method. When we add these polynomials using the horizontal method, the first thing we could do is highlight the like terms using different colors. And then, if we have colored pens or colored pencils, we could use those colors to represent the different terms in the first line of our calculations. When we add these two polynomials, it is not necessary to write them inside brackets or parentheses, since the plus sign that separates these polynomials has no effect on the signs of the terms that make up these polynomials. Next, we just have to add together all of the terms that have the same color. And it is always a good idea to start with the terms that have the highest degree and work our way down to the terms that have the lowest degree. And if you don't know what that means, then check out the link provided. So 11x cubed and 4x cubed add to give us 15x cubed. Unfortunately, there is nothing to add to our poor friend 4x squared. That doesn't mean forget about her. We still have to remember to write her in our answer. And then negative 3x and 8x add to give us 5x. And finally, 10 and negative 7 add to give us 3. We have now simplified by adding these polynomials using the horizontal method. Now, let's add these polynomials by using the vertical method. This involves creating virtual columns for each of the degrees of x, usually starting from the highest degree down to the lowest degree. When we consider the first polynomial, 11x cubed has the highest degree, and so it is written in the first column. 4x squared has the next highest degree, so it is written in the second column, followed by negative 3x in the third column, and 10, which has the lowest degree, is written in the last column. When we consider the second polynomial, 4x cubed is written in the first column. But you may notice that there is no term that contains an x squared, which means that we can leave the second column blank. However, if you like everything in order and you feel like you have to put something in the second column, you can write 0x squared, which is what we call a placeholder, because it is just holding the place in the second column, even though its value is 0. Of course, in the third column, we would write 8x, and in the last column, we would write negative 7. To get the sum of these polynomials, we simply add up the terms in each of the columns, which turns out to be 15x cubed for the first column, 4x squared for the second column, 5x for the third column, and 3 for the last column. We have now simplified this polynomial by adding using the vertical method. Okay, let's try another example where we are asked to add 3 polynomials, starting with the horizontal method. First, let's use colors to highlight all of the like terms. Next, let's use these colors in the first line of our calculations to represent the like terms. Since 3 is the highest exponent of a, we add up all of the terms that contain a cubed, which gives us 7a cubed. And then we add up all of the terms that contain a squared, which gives us 10a squared. And then all of the terms that contain a, which gives us 7a. And finally, all of the constant terms, which gives us negative 1. And now we have added these polynomials using the horizontal method. Let's try adding these polynomials again by using the vertical method. We do this by creating virtual columns for each of the powers of a, starting from the highest power down to the lowest power. The first column contains all of the a cubed, the second column contains all of the a squareds, the third column contains all of the a's, and the last column contains all of the constant terms. Now, if you don't like to see gaps in any of the columns, please feel free to put in any placeholders if it makes you feel better. Remember, to get the sum of these polynomials, we simply add the terms in each of the columns. This turns out to be 7a cubed for the first column, 10a squared for the second column, 7a for the third column, and negative 1 for the fourth column. In closing, whether we choose to add polynomials using the horizontal method or the vertical method, we will get exactly the same answer, or we should get the same answer. But whichever method you choose is a personal preference, so use the one that works best for you. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.